Okay, and we are back. So I've actually found that we have to complete Here Lies the Abyss for like any of the others. Which one was that one? What Lies Dormant? Okay. We already did that. So like I found out that we had to do the Here Lies the Abyss to get some of the other quests. But I'm not gonna do that yet because we have a shit ton to get done with our current party, and I want to make sure we get all of the options. So we're gonna go talk to Solas and Cassandra and exhaust every single option there for each of them, so that way we could get their next quest.
We must stop the wardens from carrying out this insane plan, Inquisitor, to seek out these old gods deliberately in some bizarre attempt to preempt the blight.
Grey Wardens have always been dangerous. They care for nothing beyond stopping the Darkspawn.
Like a fair maiden chasing a butterfly off a cliff. Except if you don't stop them, we'll all fall. Those fools and duty. Responsibility is not expertise. Action is not inherently superior to inaction. Forgive me. The entire idea is unnerving.
That's fair.
Inquisitor.
What do you know about the Fade?
A great deal, from my wanderings. There are a few hard facts, but I can share what I have learned.
I'd like to know more about demons.
The Chantry says that demons hate the natural world and seek to bring their chaos and destruction to the living. But such simplistic labels misconstrue their motivations, and in so doing, do all a great disservice. Spirits wish to join the living, and a demon? That wish gone wrong.
Is there a way to coexist? To live with them? If not in peace, at least without such active confrontation.
Not in the world we know today. The veil creates a barrier that makes true understanding most unlikely. But the question is a good one, and it matters that you thought to ask.
I'd like to know more about the breach.
Simply put, it is a tear in the veil between this world and the Fae, allowing spirits to enter the world physically. Small tears occur naturally when magic weakens the veil, or when spirits cluster in an area that has seen many deaths. But your anchor, as Corypheus calls it, allows you some control over the breach. That suggests it was deliberate.
I'd like to know more about the veil.
Circle mages call it a barrier between this world and the Fae, but according to my studies in ancient Elven lore, that is a vast oversimplification. Without it, imagine if spirits entered freely. The Fade was not a place one went, but a state of nature like the wind.
It sounds like it would be wonderful.
And dangerous. But yes, a world where imagination defines reality. Where spirits are as common as trees or grass. Instead, spirits are strange and fearful. And the Fade is a terrifying world touched only by mages and dreamers. I am glad that I'm not alone in seeing the beauty of such a world, along with the obvious peril.
We'll talk later.
Okay, so that's all options for the Fade.
Inquisitor.
But we still have
I need to
other
know more
options.
About Corypheus.
Ask. I will give what counsel I can.
I would like to know more about the orb he carries.
As I said, that must be the means by which he created the breach. I suspect the blast that destroyed the Conclave was more accident than anything. The result of unlocking power that had sought release for ages. What I cannot understand is how he managed to survive such an explosion.
You said that you believed the orb is elven.
I never would have believed that a Vinter mage could unlock such a powerful relic. It clearly enhances his abilities. Giving him access to power he should never have known.
Like the power to control the Archdemon.
Indirectly, one assumes. Nothing in any lore connects my people to the old god dragons who became Archdemons.
What can you tell me about the source of Corypheus's power?
According to the lore, the ancient magistars of Devinter received guidance from the old gods. Corypheus commands a false Archdemon, a corrupted old god. This suggests he no longer sees himself as their minion. Some of his unique power comes from the corruption of the Blight. The rest may come from the
What do you think Corypheus will do next?
Although you have ended the battle in Orlais, it will take the country some time to recover. Corypheus faces a decision. Accelerate his plan to gain power, or abandon his dream of conquering Orlais for now. He will never abandon his dream.
You're sure that's what he'll do?
As certain as is possible. Assuming I can plausibly predict a man who seeks to rise to godhood.
And can you?
The key is understanding this. No real god need prove himself. Anyone who tries is mad or lying. His deception will undo him, as it has done countless fools before.
I'd like to know more about you, Solas.
Why?
You're an apostate, yet you risked your freedom to help the Inquisition.
Not the wisest course of action when framed that way.
I appreciate the work you're doing, Solas. I just wanted to know more about you.
I'm sorry. With so much fear in the air. What would you know of me?
Have you always traveled and studied alone?
Not at all. I have built many lasting friendships. Spirits of wisdom, possessed of ancient knowledge, happy to share what they had seen. Spirits of purpose helped me search. Even wisps, curious and playful, would point out treasures I might have missed.
I don't know of any spirits by those names.
They rarely seek this world. When they do, their natures do not often survive exposure to the people they encounter. Wisdom and purpose are too easily twisted to pride and desire.
You're saying that you became friends with pride and desire demons?
They were not demons for me.
Meaning?
The Fade reflects the minds of the living. If you expect a spirit of wisdom to be a pride demon, it will adapt. And if your mind is free of corrupting influences, if you understand the nature of the spirit, they can be fast friends.
I'm impressed that you could become friends with spirits.
Anyone who can dream has the potential. Few ever try. My friends comforted me in grief and shared my joy. Yet, because they exist without form, as we understand it, the Chantry declares that spirits are not truly people. Is Cassandra defined by her cheekbones and not her faith? Varric by his chest hair and not his wit?
I hadn't thought about it that way, but I see your point.
I thank you. Few are willing to entertain such a notion.
What made you start studying the Fade?
I grew up in a village to the north. There was little to interest a young man, especially one gifted with magic. But as I slept, spirits of the Fade showed me glimpses of wonders I had never imagined. I treasured my dreams. Being awake, out of the Fade became troublesome.
Did spirits try to tempt you?
No more than a brightly colored fruit is deliberately tempting you to eat it. I learned how to defend myself from more aggressive spirits and how to interact safely with the rest. I learned how to control my dreams with full consciousness. There was so much I wanted to explore.
I gather you didn't spend your entire life dreaming.
No. Eventually, I was unable to find new areas in the Fade.
Why?
Two reasons. First, the Fade reflects the world around it. Unless I traveled, I would never find anything new. Second, the Fade reflects and is limited by our imaginations. To find interesting areas, one must be interested.
Is this why you joined the Inquisition?
I joined the Inquisition because we were all in terrible danger. If Corypheus destroyed the world, I would have nowhere to lay my head while dreaming of the Fade.
Ah.
Inquisitor, that is why I joined, not why I stayed.
I wish you luck.
Thank you. In truth, I've enjoyed experiencing more of life to find more of the Fade.
How so?
You train to flick a dagger or an arrow to its target. The grace with which you move is a pleasing side benefit. You have chosen a path whose steps you do not dislike because it leads to a destination you enjoy. As have I.
You said you'd traveled to many different places.
This world, or its memory, is reflected in the Fade. Dream in ancient ruins, and you may see a city lost to history. Some of my fondest memories were found in crumbling cities, long picked dry by treasure seekers, the best of the battlefields. Spirits pressed so tightly on the veil that you can slip across with but a thought.
Any place in particular?
I dreamt at Ostagar. I witnessed the brutality of the Darkspawn and the valor of the Ferelden warriors. I saw Alistair and the hero Ferelden light the signal fire, and Loghain's infamous betrayal of Caelan's forces.
I've heard the stories. It would be interesting to hear what it was really like.
That's just it. In the Fade, I see reflections created by spirits who react to the emotions of the warriors. One moment, I see heroic wardens lighting the fire, and a power-mad villain sneering as he lets King Caelan fall. The next, I see an army overwhelmed and a veteran commander refusing to let more soldiers die in a lost cause.
And you can't tell which is real.
It is the Fade. They are all real.
Okay then.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
Now, have I exhausted every single option with this?
I need to know more about Corypheus.
Although you have ended the battle in Orlais, it will take the country some time to recover. Corypheus faces a decision. Accelerate his plan to gain power, or abandon his dream of conquering Orlais for now. He will never abandon his dream.
Okay.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
So I did do all options I can. Okay. Let's go see Cullen.
First the Templars, now the Grey Wardens. Both devoted their lives to fighting evil. Now they serve it.
We brought most of the Templars over.
I thank the Maker for that, even if we were too late for some. The Inquisition must serve as an example. We must stand where others fall.
Do you have some time?
For you, always.
Yeah.
You need a break. Come on.
Yeah. That little smirk of his every fucking time. We're gonna go talk to Cassandra, exhaust every single option that we have with her. Then we are going to travel out and then back. Oh.
What have you done now?
I get it, Seeker. You're still sore God, after our spat.
I'm not a child, Varric. Do not suggest I'm without reason.
A peace offering. The next chapter of Swords and Shields. I hear you're a fan.
This is your doing.
I was hoping you'd be happy about it.
Well, if you're not interested, you're not interested. Still needs editing anyhow.
Wait!
You're probably wondering what happens to the Night Captain after the last chapter.
Nothing should happen to her. She was falsely accused.
Well, it turns out the guardsman...
Don't tell me!
This is the part where you thank the Inquisitor. I don't normally give sneak peeks, after all.
I... thank you.
This was everything I'd hoped.
I know how you feel.
I wonder if I have time to read the first part.
Don't forget to tell all your friends, if you have any. Completely worth it.
And bringing Mark was also good, because it's like, okay. Because now their little spats patched up a little bit.
Something is troubling me, Inquisitor. Leliana is receiving reports of mages becoming possessed, Templars going rogue. No one is dealing with these matters. I was hoping we might, before they get worse.
And this is her other quest.
We can certainly look into it.
I will mark these incidents on the map as I learn of them, Inquisitor. And I would be pleased to accompany you if and when you investigate.
That's enough for now.
Another time, then.
That one. Okay. I don't know how much approval I have with Iron Bull, so we're gonna go talk to him and see.
Got some new tricks, huh? That flashy stuff, all fire and crap. Good way to throw off an enemy. They get all hung up with you being on fire and miss the part where you stab them in the kidney. If you folks can do tricks like that, you might be closer than we thought to making Gatlock.
There was actually another matter I wanted to discuss.
What you got?
You said we should go get some drinks and meet your company.
Yeah, come on. It'll be fun. Ah, good. We're not drinking alone. How you doing, creme de la creme?
Your worship, I'm so glad he has someone new to hit with that joke.
Do you prefer creme or cremisius?
Creme's faster. The chief's nicknames usually end up sticking.
Hey, when I was growing up, my name was just this series of numbers. We all give each other nicknames under the cune.
They ever wear shirts under the cune, Chief? Or do they just run around binding their breasts like that?
It's a harness, Krem.
Yes, for your pillowy man bosoms. Let me know if you need help binding. You could really chisel something out of that overstuffed look.
Oh my god. I'm gonna just...
Who are the others?
A lot of the chargers went looking off for stronger drinks. Let's see, who's left? We've got Rocky and Skinner there. And over there are Stitches, Dalish, and Grim. Crazy bunch of assholes, but they're mine.
You've got a good company, Bull.
Ah, we do all right.
No man can beat the chargers, cause we'll hit you where it hurts. Unless you know a tavern with loose cards and looser skirts. For every bloody battlefield, we'll gladly raise a cup. No matter what tomorrow holds, our horns be pointing up.
Thanks for coming by, boss. Glad you could meet some of my team.
Yeah. Now we.
Pleasure as always, boss.
Okay.
See you later, Bull.
Nice talking with you, boss.
Okay. So we may need some more approval with him. Okay, so we're gonna go back to Western Approach. since I've completed that operation, I should be able to get around and down. But Blackwell, that is our party.
Nothing to report, sir.
That's the grandmother of all locks. We're not getting in here. Inquisitor.
Thank you. did this, you pay.
we knock?
It will be my pleasure.
How long can they keep this up? Inquisitor, you want your very own fort in the middle of nowhere?
It has water and a good tactical location.
Inquisitor, you're early. We've barely been set up a week. I have a patrol out at the moment. Some of the men sighted Darkspawn in the area. I have reports that bandits have taken up squatting in the fortress the Wardens abandoned. We're reasonably well entrenched here, but the Keep's water supply has been problematic. It's causing delays. I'll prepare the troops for inspection at once.
What's wrong with the water supply?
The fort's well is full of garbage. blasted Venatori threw corpses in there. There's an oasis nearby, but a Vargast claimed it. Doing a decent job of keeping us away, too. Four soldiers have already fallen to venom and claws. We'll need reinforcements to drive the monster out.
What can you tell me about the Darkspawn in the area?
The Darkspawn seem to have emerged since we took the keep. I've warned the troops not to engage unless absolutely necessary. We don't need a blight in the ranks. We have to find whatever hole the monsters came from and seal it.
Report. What's the situation in the Warden's Fortress?
Bandits moved in. Worse than Quillbacks, if you ask me. They're holed up in there, using it as a base to strike at our supply caravans. Blasted scavengers.
Carry on, Captain.
Yes, Inquisitor.
We're slowly driving them back. Good.
Sense elven magic somewhere nearby.
Yesterday.
More riddles. What was really happening here? Thank you.